Well, here's an interesting story. If you've followed my vlog for a little while, you remember several months back, I lost my wallet. Actually, it fell out of my pants, and well, here's a little snippet of what happened that time. Months went by. Finally, I told Gloria, you know what, now that we got the chariot that requires a driver's license, we need to get my driver's license back. I have the receipt that had the driver's license number on it. So, first thing we did, well, we went over and told our friend and neighbor, Jaime and Davina. Jaime has been a guard for many years, and he's a, what they call a comandante. So he's kind of up there in the guard position, whether that means anything or not. He wanted to come along. So Jaime hopped in the back with Gloria. We went to LTO, which means Land Transportation Office, I believe. This is like the Department of Transportation or the DMV, Department of Motor Vehicles. It's where you go to get driver's license and different license for, I don't know. You can tell. I'm kind of in a frustration mode. So we went there.
We just came out of the LTO. That's where they, that's where they issue the driver's license. But we told them that mine was lost, and so they said that we have to go to the police station, get an affidavit that was lost, show my ID, which I have my California driver's license, and go back.
Lady was very nice. She said, you need to go to the police department to get an affidavit of that your driver's license wasn't taken away by the police. Need to go to a lawyer to say that you you make an official statement. I lost my driver's license. I swear I did. And then back to the LTO. So first step, we went to the police department. They said, do you have your affidavit of loss from the lawyer? No, you got to go to the lawyer and get it.
I thought Jaime was going to get gas. I thought, no, I just filled it up yesterday. So now we got to break that 1,000 and go to the lawyer to get this affidavit of loss. And, he's not going to be able to break 1,000 pesos.
So we went to the lawyer. And this is a very interesting thing. We went to this, I guess like a city hall. They call it municipal. And had a lot of offices, bureaucratic, you know, paperwork stuff. Went to a lawyer. Told him what we needed, and so I kept a receipt for my driver's license, so I had the receipt number there. And he asked a few questions, what happened? I said I was in my recall, electric tricycle, and the wallet fell out of my pocket, and I went back to go look for it, and I couldn't find it anyplace.
Oh, yeah.
A very interesting part. He typed up, this is next to the most interesting part. He typed up his report, signed it, had me sign it, and then we took off. He said, take this to the police department. So went to the police department, but before we got there, about halfway, I said, Jaime, look, this form said, this day, 10 March, but actually that day, which a couple days ago, was 10 April. So my first thought was, well, maybe they won't notice it. Tommy said, no, let's take him back, tell him he made a mistake. So took him back and said,
date. Put down today is the 10th of March, 10th of April. Just warned you before me this day, hang on, 10th day of March.
Says 10 March, it should be 10 April. This is the first time I've ever been to a lawyer. So now here's the kicker. He changed, I had no problem. So he changed it. And then I said, Bayad, I mean, it's the bill. So I had no idea what it was going to cost. So he said, no, this is no charge. He said, you're my neighbor. You live just a block away. I see you coming and going every day. What? I said, well, can I have your business card? Then I'll give you a recommendation. So my question is, what about that white skin tax? You know, the foreigner tax that everybody talks about. I'm supposed to be getting charged more because, you know, I'm a foreigner. What about that? Of course. I didn't say it, I'm just being a smart aleck. But how about that? I'm his neighbor, so no charge. It's a good one. And when will you hear the charges coming up? So, we got it corrected, had four copies, and went down to the police department. Thank you. And he was asking me, I thought he had, there was another lady sitting right in front of him. I thought he was filling out her paperwork. And I didn't know that Jaime had given him my these forms from the lawyer. And that he would, the police was making out his own report. So he said, are you married? And I thought that he was just like being friendly. Oh yeah, I've been married a long time. Your wife's Philippine? Oh yeah, not the route. Sure, of course. So, you know, I'm shucking and jiving, but he's asking me these legitimate questions that have to go on his form. Oh, I wish I would have known that. I'd been a little bit more formal. But, he finishes it. Jaime takes the book and goes and gets it. I guess there's a copier in another building. So I sit there and I'm talking with him. And then Jaime gets back and I said, well, what's the charge on that? He says, 3. So I start to pull out 300 pesos. Tommy, and Jaime says, no, 3. 3 pesos. What? 3 pesos? Gosh, I can't believe it. So I pull up a little change, 1, 2, 3 pesos. But what about I'm sorry to be cynical, but you know, I just have not experienced it. I know I'm out here in the province, and I'm not saying it doesn't happen. But I can only share my experience. Well, anyway, I don't want to keep going with that, but that cost me 3 pesos. And then we had the lawyer copies, we had the police report. Now we go back to the LTO. And so we got there and it was really crowded. For some reason, well, this is what they call Semana Santa, Holy Week, week before Easter. And,
Vasquez. Vasquez.
Fill out some more forms and come back next week. Jaime.
Hey, what?
Hey, mo?
She said, come back Monday. So I'm not sure if she means there'll be less people Monday, or you have to wait. Oh, and then fill out this form. So I fill out I'll fill out the form, take it back Monday, pay whatever the fee is. It's gonna be minimal, I know. And then I'll have my Filipino driver's license again. So, hope you liked this video. It was a nice little downtown adventure, and I also have a story maybe tomorrow about our first modification on the chariot. So talk to you later. Bye bye.